Hi guys, my name's Noelle. I am gonna run you guys through a quick 20 minute yoga flow that I like to do. I'm far from a professional. I don't consider myself to be a yogi or anything like that, but this is something that I've started getting into in the past, I'd say 2 years, and I do a lot of classes and a lot of practice in my free time. It's something that makes me feel really relaxed. I also have a really bad hamstring injury, which gives me lack of flexibility in one of my legs, so this helps a lot with that as well. And I just find it a really great way to connect your mind and body. So after a stressful day, or sometimes I just feel throughout the days I'm not present. I'm always thinking about other things, you know, things I have to do later in the day or things I'm supposed to do without, you know, like throughout the week. So this is something that helps me kind of center myself and feel present. So I hope you guys enjoy. Let's get your mats and a water bottle and let's get started. Oh yes, and I see you guys mentioning the polar bear. This is my friend in the back. I love this picture. And so I thought I would put you guys right in front of him. Let's get started. I'm gonna turn on some music here. With that said, let's see. Get a class. Reach your hands up to the sky. Inhale. Exhale and fall forward. Think about your forehead touching the mat here. And try to keep your sit bones grounded on the mat. Then you get the best stretch. Start with a cat cow. So start pushing your hips down. Reach your head up. Take a deep breath in. And now we're going to go into down dog. Start with your knees bent and just see how your hamstrings feel, because this is a really tight stretch in the beginning if you haven't stretched yet today. I like to pedal out my feet, see how everything feels. Just take it at your own pace. Breathe in deeply. Now we're going to walk our feet to the top of the mat, going into forward fold. You can bend your knees. Now just spread your feet about hip width apart and just grab each elbow, rock in between. I like to put my hands down, shake my head no, shake my head yes. Just kind of move around. It doesn't have to look good. Whatever feels good to you. Take deep breaths. Think about getting your forehead closer to your legs. I sadly can't. As I told you guys, I have a hamstring injury, so I lose a lot of flexibility from that, sadly. Now inhale. Reach both arms up to the sky. Exhale, hands to heart center. Inhale, hands to the sky. Exhale. Reach down to the mat. Now we're going to step our right foot back into your lunge. And when you feel stable and ready, just come up into high lunge. This is such a good stretch for the hips. Make sure your front knee is directly on top of your ankle. And just breathe. Now slowly release your arms. You're going to put your back knee down and extend your front knee. Just get a really nice hamstring stretch there in the front. Roll out your ankle. If you're like me, I have really tight hamstrings, so this is such a good stretch. Deep breath in through your nose. And long exhale out. Flexing your front foot will give you a bigger stretch. Slowly come back into a little lunge. Lift your back knee. And you're going to lift your hand up to the sky. This is such a nice twist. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. Release your arm. Let's go back up into high lunge. Stay here for one breath. Deep breath in. Exhale, dive your arms down. Now step your back leg into plank position, and we're going to do chaturanga. So I think the easiest version is to put your knees down, lower down, come up into upward dog. Inhale in, and exhale into downward dog.
No one's going.
Bend your knees and let's meet in child's pose. And just take a moment here to breathe. This is my favorite position. Let's go back onto all fours and meet back in downward dog. Inhale. Exhale. One more time. Now bend your knees, look towards the front of your mat and either step or hop to the front. Take a deep breath. Forward fold. Roll up. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, hands to heart. Inhale, arms up again. Exhale, dive yourself all the way down. Inhale, halfway lengthen. Exhale, release your leg. Now you're gonna step that opposite leg back. Stable, let's go into high lunge. This should be a really good stretch for your hip flexors. Deep breath in. Exhale. Release both arms to the crown. Bring your weight into your back knee. And then we're going to stretch this hamstring. Try and keep your hips square. It will give you a much better stretch. And like I said, if you flex this foot, you'll get a much better stretch in your hamstring. This is such a hard one. Center. And now we're going to bring the other arm up to get that twist again. Stay here and breathe. Try and look up towards that top arm. Beautiful. Let's come back up into high lunge. Ooh. Release your hands down. Let's go into plank and back into chaturanga. Inhale and then exhale into down dog. Bend your knees and straighten them again a few times. That's going to help loosen your hamstring. Inhale. Exhale. Back down in child's pose. Take a moment here and focus on your breath. Arms reaching forward, inhale through your nose, and exhale, let it all go. One more time. gonna meet back on our mats in what I like to call a butterfly. So let's just sit down, put the heels of your feet together. Inhale, and let's exhale forward. This is a really good exercise to open up your hips. I have really tight hips because I sit a lot on planes and traveling and all of that, so this is really good for my hips. Such a nice stretch. You can make it harder by pushing down on your knees with your elbows a little bit. Inhale, reach your arms up to the sky. Exhale, hands to heart. Things that I'm thankful for, even if it's just small, like something small that happened to you today or a person in your life that you're thankful for. I know it sounds cheesy, but I think it's a great practice, practicing gratitude. Take one last inhale, exhale, and that's it, guys. Thank you guys for practicing with me. I'm curious to see if anyone has any questions before I get off here. I see my sissy on here. Hi, sissy. I'm glad you guys enjoyed this. Something different than the other.
Get off here. I see my sissy on here. Hi, sissy.
Thank you guys so much for joining. Sorry, I'm just trying to read all your questions here.
Thank you guys.
Do I eat it all? Yes, I do. I eat quite a bit.
Sorry, I'm just trying to read all your questions.
How often do I practice? So, it varies for me. I try and practice as much as I can, but I'm quite inconsistent. So sometimes I practice 5 days a week, and sometimes it's a lot less than that. But I do it as much as I can. I'd say on average I practice about 3 times a week. I'm not certified. I'm not yoga teacher certified. I've wanted to do that for a long time, but it takes a lot of consistency, which is tough with my job because I'm always traveling and I have a very inconsistent schedule, so I've never been able to do the programs that I've wanted to, but that's something that I hope to do someday when I have a bit of free time. I see people asking how I got into modeling. I got into modeling when I was in high school. I was scouted by a local agency. I'm from Missouri, and so I was scouted by a local agency. And shortly after, I moved to New York, and it's never something that I expected to do, but it's been a very exciting journey, and I'm so happy that I was brought into this world. So I'm very thankful for my job. I love it. There's so many questions. Okay, so I think I'm gonna log off now, guys. Thank you so much for watching my yoga flow, and I hope you enjoyed. I hope that it brought some movement to your day and you guys could de-stress for a little bit. I know it's hard sitting inside everybody right now, so it's good to get moving in any way you can, I think. If I wake up in the morning and just do this 20-minute flow, it changes my entire day. I feel healthier, I feel more awake, I feel present, and I really find it so beneficial. So I hope that I could help you guys just get inspired to get moving, and I hope you all have a great day. Thank you!